Are you actually living your best life? Like, are you leveling up each day and getting one step closer to achieving your goals and kind of manifesting the vision you have for your life? If the answer is no, or maybe, you're completely fine. I was in the same boat, am still in the same boat often, but with the help of a little intentionality, I have found that I am well on my way to truly living my best life. Stick around and hear more. Hello everyone, I am Alnita, wife, mom, JD MBA, and business strategy consultant, and I am the founder of The Strategic Mom. On this channel, I share tips and strategies for helping you live life more joyfully, intentionally, and authentically while raising children who are empowered to do the same. Today, on this video, I'm going to talk a little bit more about intentionality. What is it? How you can apply it to your life, and what next steps you can take to start applying intentionality to all of the different things we juggle as parents, as moms, as professionals, and as people. So, if you are intrigued by this idea, if you are at all wanting to live life more joyfully, intentionally, and authentically, then don't be afraid, sis. Click that subscribe button, click the notifications bell so you can hear more about this information and my content as soon as it drops. What is intentionality? Intentionality is defined as acting purposefully or deliberately. It literally just means thinking about things and doing things on purpose. Intentionality comes from the root word intentio, which means directed at. So I want you to think of yourself as an archer. Your brain is your bow, and your thoughts and intentions are your actions. If we are acting with intentionality, we are looking at each of our targets very clearly, zoning in on them, and then directing our intentions, our thoughts, our actions, so that we are purposefully hitting them. Now, when you don't act with intentionality, which we often do, you are shooting your thoughts, shooting your intentions, and a lot of times your actions, investing your time, your energy, and your money in a way that is haphazard. You know, you're hitting things, but they may not necessarily be the targets that you want to hit. You're not living life on purpose and with purpose, and that's okay. Sometimes you don't want to do that, but we shouldn't make that a habit, especially if we want to live our best life, especially if we want to manifest the life that we have in our head and make sure that our kids, you know, our families are set up for the success that we envision. So that's why intentionality is so important. It gives us clarity. It gives us purpose, and it helps us to truly create the life that you have in your head, that you know that you deserve, that you know that you want, that you know that your kids deserve, because you are acting, investing your time, which we only have so much of, investing your money, which we only have so much of, in a way that effectively serves those, that vision, those goals, those values that are most important to you. You're probably wondering, okay, so how can I apply this whole thing? The first thing you have to do if you want to apply and live life with more intentionality is to figure out what the heck you want, to figure out your why. And the first step in figuring out your why is defining your core values. Core values are the beliefs that are most important to us. This can be anything from family and financial security, creativity, altruism, helping other people, faith, to absolutely anything else. I mean, there are so many value assessments out there if you want an example of all of the different potential words and potential ways of describing your values. I actually did you one better and created a values assessment that you can click the link in the description to access based on things that I found to be most helpful, but you have to figure out what is most important to you first. So you have to define your core values. Once you define your core values, you have to set a vision for your life. What do you want your life to look like? I feel like a very attainable time frame is to either think about 3 years or 5 years. What do you want your life to look like? And think about it from the dimension of what do I want my life to look like as it pertains to myself and my personal care, my personal development? What do I want my life to look like as it pertains to my children, their care, their development? What do I want my life to look like in terms of the relationships, the people who are most important to me, the people who I want to make sure I invest in? What does my life look like in terms of my finances? You know, what my budgeting, the investing, the saving. So you want to think about defining a vision along those dimensions and always thinking about whether or not that vision aligns with those core values that you've now defined for your life. So you've defined your values, you've set a vision. Now that you've set that vision, you got to get some goals. We have to determine our goals. And as someone who has been a project manager for some major business transformation, I so appreciate goals. Goals are nothing more than broken down, achievable milestones and almost like lampposts that we can say, once I check this box, I know that I am on my way and on the right path to delivering this long-term vision that I have. So a really nice way that I found to determine your goals is by using a concept known as backwards planning. So shout out to all my teachers who understand backwards planning and how to use it for the curriculum. It is a great strategy to also use for defining your goals. So the way that backwards planning works is you'll define what vision do I have, like I said, at that time frame or 3 years or 5 years for my life. Again, going back to those four dimensions of self-care and development, childcare and development, relationships and finances. And then asking yourself the question, if this needs to be true in 3 years or 5 years, then where do I need to be in 2 years? Where do I need to be in 1 year? What needs to be true in 9 months? What needs to be true in 6 months? What needs to be true in 2 weeks? This is a way of basically creating a step-by-step, paint-by-numbers start roadmap to achieving that vision that looks at where do I want to end up? What outcome do I want to drive toward? And it's very effective. So you want to figure out your core values. You want to define a vision for your life. You want to set some goals. And finally, you want to refine those goals by evaluating your current state. We cannot just aimlessly say, all right, let's go, let's deliver our goals without understanding where are we? What are our current habits? What are things that we're currently doing that are in line and actually pushing us towards our goals and towards that vision and allowing us to deliver on those core values? And what are some things that we're doing that maybe aren't pushing us towards those goals or actually preventing us from delivering on those core values and that vision? So a good thing I like to do is, you know, ask yourself, now that you have those goals set, kind of describe, create a little description of how would I describe myself here now. So what, maybe finance is one of your goals is I want to be debt free. Well, then you would look at, well, how much debt do I have now? Where is that debt? You know, how much am I paying on it each month? What are some of the things that I'm doing that are creating more debt? These are all the things that you want to look at from the perspective of your current state so that you can effectively start to deliver on that future state. So all of this, same concepts I use with a lot of companies, but very, very effective to use this, these same strategies with your life. Remember, we're going to start with defining our core values, figuring out what is a vision that we have for our life, defining some goals, and then evaluating our current state to see where are we now so we can close the gap between where we are and where we want to be. This will allow you to have a broad framework, almost like a strategy of sorts, to deliver on so you can act with more intention. You can act and you can zone in on those goals, that vision, your targets, and use your intentions, your thoughts, those arrows to hit them, baby. Bullseye. Bullseye is what we're going for. Hashtag bullseye. Where do I begin? Well, what we did, my husband and I, is we decided to carve up and think about the different areas of our lives that we focus on and we need to juggle as parents, as professionals, as people. And so those four areas that we defined are childcare and development, really about the physical, mental, emotional well-being of our daughter and what are some of the goals we have there, doing those that same exercise, what are our values, what are our goals, what's our current state as it pertains to that area. Then we thought about self-care and development, and we did this both individually and collectively. What are the, you know, what are some goals for our physical, you know, our spiritual, our emotional self-care and personal development? The next area is finances. What are some goals that we have and values and understanding our current state as it pertains to budgeting and saving and investing? And finally, last but definitely not least, one of the most important areas is relationships. What's a vision? What are our goals? What are our values? And what's our current state as it pertains to relationships, familial relationships, you know, friends, any relationships, you know, romantic, the relationship we have with each other, our partnership. What do we want that to look like? What's important for us there? And then let's set some goals, understand our current state so that we can close the gap and get there. So I actually have created a quick little worksheet for you so that you can do a similar exercise that we're doing. Once you've defined these things, you have to put them up somewhere. You know, once you see things over and over again, it's easier to manifest them, but you have to figure out what you want. And then you have to start acting in a way that allows you to really manifest those things you want. So if you found this interesting, again, if this even just made you say, click the subscribe button, click the notifications bell. Let me know your thoughts and comments below. I'm intrigued. I especially want you to let me know, what area of your life do you want to prioritize acting with more intentionality around? Maybe it's childcare and development. I know a lot of us are now teaching our kids from home. Thank you, COVID-19. So maybe you are trying to figure out how you can do that with more intentionality. Maybe it's self-care and development. Maybe you feel quite burnt out trying to juggle being a mom, being a wife, being, you know, a professional, all these other things. And you need to focus in on what are the things that bring you joy and making sure that you're delivering on that so you can pour into other people. Guess what? Let me know what area you're trying to be more intentional around. Like I said, click the subscribe button, click the notifications bell. Excited to have you all along for the journey, and I'm excited to hear more about you all's experiences with intentionality. Thanks so much for joining. Alnita again, the Strategic Mom. Peace, love, and intentionality, people. Bye-bye.